Welcome to the new sectionalized landing page, a unified entry point designed for all users across targeted roles, such as an employee, manager, business analyst, and more. The new FSCM landing page provides an inviting, informative, and content-rich user experience that suggests tasks for you to complete and guides you to unfinished tasks. This modern interface streamlines access to your most relevant content and actionable items and enhances user productivity by reducing time spent navigating to multiple pages. FSCM Update Image 55 delivers a sample landing page that leverages the new styling capabilities in PeopleTools 8.6.2, giving full control over the look and feel of the homepage, dashboards, sections, and tile objects in the application using CSS. Examples of the styling capabilities include the textured background of the landing page, section border shapes, section background colors, and tiles styled as buttons or links. Some sections display navigation and content on the landing page that is dynamically generated using Notification Composer. In-app notifications are published to the landing page and have configurable icons and text that generate a tile, which is based on criteria and a recipient list. You can dismiss these one-time or recurring notifications, or the system will automatically dismiss them when the criteria are no longer met or when the expiration date is met. There are four Notification Composer-based sections provided: Banner Announcements, Suggestions, Continue With, and Announcements. The Welcome section provides a personalized user greeting, today's date, and optionally displays a photo if resource management is installed. Critical system-wide messages appear front and center in the Banner Announcement section. Important updates, such as system outages or policy changes, are communicated to all users. Only one high-priority message displays at a time, ensuring clear communication. The Suggestions section displays real-time, system-identified tasks that need your attention. These notifications are actionable and guide you to complete high-priority activities. Examples include approvals awaiting action, match exceptions, submit your wallet changes, and more. You can select a tile to access the page where you can act on one or more transactions. The Approvals Awaiting Action tile takes you to the Pending Approvals page, where an approver can access and act on the transaction. Use the Edit icon to access a View All page, which is available from the Suggestions, Continue With, and Announcements sections. Use the View All page to filter by transaction type, dismiss a transaction, or manage all outstanding tasks or suggestions in one centralized space. The Continue With section contains unfinished transactions begun by the user. It helps users pick up where they left off. Transactions that support Save for Later, Marked as Incomplete, or activity guides that are in process and allow you to exit and save your place appear in this section. The tiles in this section provide quick navigation back to the unfinished transaction. Example transactions configured for Continue With include Payment Request, Pending Expense Reports, Pending Travel Authorizations, and more. A View All link appears when more notifications are available in the section. When a task is submitted or completed, it's removed from the Continue With section. When all tasks are complete, an All Caught Up badge appears in this section. Announcements provide a space for targeted, contextual messages to segmented user groups. Select an announcement to view additional information. Each announcement notification can include rich content, links, or images. Use the Quick Access section to access frequently used self-service transactions. Tiles are available based on user security, maximizing efficiency, and reducing search time. The Travel and Expenses tile takes you to a redesigned dashboard where you can access approvals, all expense transactions, inquiries and reports, and insights. The My Work section consolidates functional tiles and essential job tasks into a single area. Users see only the tiles relevant to the responsibilities. The tiles in this section provide quick navigation links to components such as approvals and work centers. PeopleSoft FSCM delivers sample sections that you can use, such as finance and accounting, project costing, e-procurement, and more. This structure supports business processes and replaces the old home pages. The recently visited Favorites and My Favorite Searches sections provide you with a subset of the recently visited navigation items, navigation you favorited, or saved searches that have been favorited in the application. The footer is configurable and allows you to specify text. The sectionalized landing page transforms how organizations engage with core applications. With role-adapted content, actionable notifications, and streamlined access, teams spend more time on high-value work. Organization administrators can copy delivered section templates and customize them to fit specific needs using standard PeopleTools features. Role and security settings ensure each user only sees the tiles they're permitted to access. This completes our demonstration of the landing page. Notification Publisher enables you to publish organizational news and alerts through email, in-app notifications, or text messaging using PeopleSoft Notification Composer. With PeopleTools 8.6.2, in-app notifications can publish the information directly to a landing page section, such as the banner announcements and announcements sections, ensuring timely and consistent communication. Notification Composer adds Notification Publisher as a new source to support publishing notifications using this framework. When selected, the system pre-populates the notification link page with parameters for the notification details page, which is the default page that displays the details of the selected announcement on the landing page. The Publish Notifications page is now available in Fluid for users to compose and send notifications. The system delivers the banner announcements category specifically for publishing system-wide announcements for the landing page, like system alerts. General notification is the default category. It's not used for the landing page. You can create categories for publishing notifications in the announcements section. In this example, use department budget. The View Category Details link appears if the selected category is linked to a notification event ID from Notification Composer. Information is displayed about the associated notification event, such as the landing page section where the notification will appear. The notification can be published immediately or at a future date. You can add an expiration date to dismiss the notification after a specific date. You can even set up a daily, weekly, or monthly recurring schedule for the notification through advanced options. Specify who should receive the notification. You can target all users, users of specific roles, or custom groups using recipient types. Use the Override Notification Content option to edit the default content before publishing. You can insert a predefined page link or attachments for recipients to access additional resources if applicable. Review and publish the notification. The Publish Notification appears in the Announcements section of the landing page for the target audience. Select to view the announcement. This completes our demonstration of Notification Publisher. The new Customization Insights combines your customizations with PUM metadata, providing an intuitive view of your customizations and enabling you to make data-driven decisions. You'll see the customization level for your application, which customizations have been impacted by application maintenance, those that haven't been used recently, which product area a customization affects, and more. When you enable Usage Monitor in your environments, over time you'll see which customizations are used. You can also see which product area has used or unused customizations. When your customization data is combined with the PUM metadata, you can see when your customizations were impacted by delivered changes. Enhanced PUM metadata comes with 862-based PeopleSoft update images. If you haven't applied the latest image, you can also see which customizations will be impacted by future maintenance. The customization impacts is more than a count of customizations. It shows you how many times your customizations were impacted by delivered update images. Use this data to find which customizations require more effort to maintain. Like every Insights dashboard, select a graph to filter the data. Selecting a row lets you investigate which objects will be impacted. The data table included in the Customization Insights dashboard shows which objects are impacted. PeopleTools 862 includes the tools to calculate and populate the Insights data. FSCM Update Image 55 includes the Customization Insights dashboard as well as the enhanced PUM metadata that power the insights. To get started with Customization Insights, you must be on PeopleTools 862 and apply the patches from this FSCM image to your target environments. Then you can use the delivered wizard in Change Assistant to populate your customization insights. Refer to the PeopleTools 862 highlights video for more information. This completes our demonstration of customization insights. PeopleSoft General Ledger is the first to add interactive insights to My Work sections within a WorkCenter. This is an enterprise components feature that is configured on the Configure Pagelets My Work page. FSCM Update Image 55 delivers the Journals Ready for Post option to optionally allow a visualization that displays valid journals that may have missed the batch posting process. The visualization is interactive, meaning you can select a specific section in the visualization, which alters the chart below. From the grid, you can drill to journal details to view and post or update the journal. This completes the interactive insights in WorkCenters feature description. PeopleSoft enhances the Reconcile P-Card Statement page to provide a configurable approval workflow for procurement card transactions. Use this page to submit transactions and track the approval status. In addition, the Pending Approvals page includes the Procurement Card section. Use this section to review and approve procurement card transactions and access header details for a specific transaction. This completes the Procurement Card Approval Enhancements description. PeopleSoft Inventory now includes the PAR Location and PAR Location Activity Insights dashboards. These dashboards provide enhanced visibility and analytical insights into PAR locations, PAR item counts, and PAR inventory activity across business units. Use the PAR Location dashboard to view and analyze the number of PAR locations, PAR items, and their distribution across business units. This dashboard helps you track replenishment options, identify common PAR items, and monitor inventory definitions for better operational visibility. Use the PAR Location Activity dashboard to monitor PAR counting events, track completion status, and analyze inventory activities across different locations. This dashboard helps you manage inventory counts, identify zero stock items, and review replenishment actions efficiently. This completes the Insights for PAR Replenishments Activity feature description. The My Proxy Expense Activity Dashboard provides a consolidated view of expense and travel activity, including reports submitted by you and on behalf of others. Key filters allow you to customize your view based on preparer, business unit, expense type, and department. Use the expense visualizations to monitor critical metrics, such as policy violations, report status, corporate card spending, and expense denials. All visualizations can be filtered using the intuitive controls at the top of the page. Use the travel authorizations by status visualization to quickly assess the volume and value of travel requests that are pending, approved, or denied. This provides immediate insight into approval workflows. Use the travel authorizations denied by expense type visualization to view denied travel authorizations categorized by each expense type. Use the travel authorizations data grid to review detailed information for each travel authorization that is relevant to you, both direct and proxy, with full filtering and direct access to record details. These updates bring unified reporting, streamlined analytics, and improved oversight of both expenses and travel authorizations, all within a single dashboard. This completes the Proxy Insights for Travel Authorizations feature description. This list provides additional features and enhancements added for FSCM Update Image 55. Page and Field Configurator allows you to override application default values with a value that is determined on the page configuration page. It also enables real-time indexing for Page and Field Configurator change tracking insights. General Ledger allows you to add, update, or delete comments associated with the journal entry, add a long description and up to 5 reference fields to journal entry templates and journal entry line pages, improve InVision drill-down layouts, and select the Do Not Roll Forward Zero Balances option on the Closing Rules Roll Forward Options page for the Close Ledger Application Engine process. Billing adds the ability to configure which fields are required and should be validated during the billing interface process. Receivables allows you to modify attachments for posted payments, generate XML files in CDAR for France, and includes 4 new fields to the Excel upload template for direct journal accounting entries. Treasury supports bank statements in the ISO 20022 format. The Procurement WorkCenter includes 3 new exceptions: denied purchase orders, purchase order dispatch errors, and exceptions related to requisitions. Supplier Contract Management adds the ability to send DocuSign notifications to alert signatories of documents pending their signature. Maintenance Management adds the ability to copy a work order to a different business unit, select which fields to copy, and modify the new work order. Asset Management adds the ability to print location codes as QR codes or barcodes. We've only shown you the highlights of the features in this PeopleSoft update image. For more information about these features and the other enhancements, see the CFO tool, the update image overview on My Oracle Support, and go to the PeopleSoft information portal for updates.